A pleasure to meet all at last, and today it's May 3rd, 2024. And as you might have guessed, I made two whole tier list videos for Nerf Secret Reveal Tears of the Clown in a retrospective image for the Rebel line. And that's because there's a lot of blasters and a lot of stuff to cover. And this actually will be the third and final part in the whole series itself. I mean, I've had so much to talk about based on the Rebel line itself that it's crazy. It's a really big lineup. It lasted from 2013 through 2018. So without further ado, let's go finish from what we started, or where we started. We had one part, then two, and this will be the last. So, shrunken down to the corner again. And we're basically going to pick up from where we left off again, but unlike with the last two parts where we covered the original lineup plus the Super Soakers, we're going to get in touch with some of the other sub-series that came around. Sub-lineups, of course, that included the likes of the Charmed Collection and the Wild Glam Collection. We'll basically cover through all of that starting now. We're going to go and get started with the AccuStrike retrospect. Yeah, that's right. In the same way that there were a couple of Mega Blasters that came out alongside the AccuStrike line when it first came out in 2019, there also were Rebel Blasters. This was essentially the last that Rebel had to offer alongside the supposed Platinum Bow, which, as I've mentioned, was unfortunately scrapped. So, three blasters came out from the Rebel AccuStrike line, and we're going to start off with the Combo. This actually is a unique piece, mostly for the fact that it's actually two blasters in one. You have a compound bow that supports a top portion, plus a regular blaster with a stock that makes up the bottom portion. And this blaster itself tends to act much like a normal blaster, or I could be more specific, much like that of the Guardian crossbow, minus the arms. However, with the top portion of the combo, it's basically a compound bow stacked on top of the blaster itself. So it has that sort of combiner feel to it, similar in a way to Transformers or even Voltron. So I can't entirely be that negative about it because it seems like a unique innovation. But unfortunately, this, along with the other two blasters, which I'll get to in a bit, have technically slipped my mind because they unfortunately were released in a very limited quantity, making them extremely rare, especially nowadays when many years have passed since this one moment in life came and went. So the combo and two other blasters, which I'll get to right about now, so we'll put combo at B because I know it's not perfect, and I'm sure that with a few tweaks, it could actually be a masterpiece in its own right. The second blaster that came from the Rebel AccuStrike line is the Focus Fire. This too was much like that of the Guardian crossbow in terms of its overall design, but it had a large iron sight in the front, and it also had itself a pretty sizable capacity. But I can't exactly be too sure about this one, contrary to what the combo could potentially offer. And so, being that it does recycle a lot of design cues, we'll just put it at around C for some good measure. I'm a bit neutral about this one. The third and final blaster released in this sub-series is the True Point. And as you can pretty much tell, it's the smallest of the bunch. Now, like I've said, it's been incredibly hard for me to find any of these AccuStrike Rebel blasters. And even if I do find listings on eBay, for instance, it's only on rare occasions. And a lot of times they are quite expensive, much like how some other blasters or even blaster components or accessories and whatnot, like the Elite 50 Dart Drum. That alone is an impressive value. If someone got a hold of it, it'd be like holding onto a large piece of silver. But in any case though, the True Point actually is supposedly a great blaster. In spite of its small size, I would probably consider it to be almost like that of a Nightfinder or something like that. And I guess for that reason, it does in fact deserve a good ranking. So we'll just leave it at A for that reason. And that makes up the Rebel AccuStrike lineup. Now we're going to get on to some of the other blasters. And for this occasion, we'll start off with the Charm Collection, beginning with the Everfears. I don't exactly talk much about a lot of these blasters, but I feel like that with this very occasion, I could probably give them a chance. The Everfears itself is a smaller size blaster, contrary to what we've seen before with the lineup itself. And all four of the blasters that came from the Charm lineup are known for having their excessive amounts of jewelry, chains, and other such faux add-ons that they put onto the blaster's overall molding. And I will say, at least with this being a compound bow variation of the bunch, the Everfears bow holding some darts in place, similar in a design to that of the Mega Thunder bow, because the darts are, after all, put in a barrel arrangement with a smart AR system, top to bottom, essentially. So I can't exactly be that comparative to it as the Thunder bow, but at the same time, I'm not exactly getting much high hopes out of this. Mostly because the Thunder bow itself was already a bit of a revolution for utilizing Nerf darts in a compound bow design, and also having its own smart AR system, allowing the darts to come out easily without issue. So I guess in that case, we'll just put the Everfears bow at around C for the reason of it not being as big as the Thunder bow, although I'm sure that it could have its own set of fans. Next, we'll move on to the Dauntless. This is another smaller blaster and once again has that sort of Knife Finder-like feel to it due to it having a priming rod and a grip and a set of barrels. A simplistic design complete with those charm feels to it, accessorizing and whatnot, giving all that unique feel. But this is yet another occasion where I probably can't talk much about this one. Although I'm sure that the Dauntless, it actually is a pretty good blaster in its own way. So I feel like that with little stuff worth telling, I'll probably just put it at B, only for the reason that it does have that Knife Finder look to it, and thereby could actually prevail to some degree. We'll get to the last two blasters here. The Fair Fortune is up next. A crossbow design that can hold darts. Yeah, that's basically what it is. For 2015, I'm sure Nerf had a lot of ideas coming through, especially when they were putting their minds with the likes of the Mega, Elite, Zombie Strike, and even the new Modulus line during that whole time. So it's been a busy year for them, and I'm sure that they would have had a lot of ideas put around, but there are plenty of crossbow blasters out there that could do Nerf darts or even actual arrows with ease. And I can't say much about this one, nor do I know much about this one. So we'll just leave the Fair Fortune at C. Then we have the Gracefire. I consider this one to be unique because of this Daisy Derringer-like design that it has. But other than that, much like the other Charm Blasters, not much I could say about this one. So another C ranking, it'll pretty much just be. And next we have ourselves the Code Red Collection, of which we are going to start off with the Agent Bow. Yes, it's another one of those blasters that utilizes the actual arrows. And I'm sure that a lot of people out there would have fallen in love with this blaster, but considering all the bows and all the crossbows and all the transforming wing bows, like the Wing Speed, which I've talked about before, there's just so many ideas out there that I feel like Nerf could have executed with the Rebel line. All these different bows and all these different things that I'm sure that have been put on repeat, it just gets a bit old. So the Agent Bow can just simply be put down at C. And the second blaster, and only other blaster of the bunch, is known as the Sweet Mystery. This came in its own pack and is little more than just another Jolt. Yeah, 7 Jolt blasters from the original lineup itself, and now there's another one for the Code Red collection. I mean, you know what? I feel like it is what it is. It's a Jolt blaster. It could be in the B tier. Not much more to say from there. And then, of course, we have ourselves the Remix Collection. This collection itself consisted of a few blasters in its own way. We have ourselves the Duet, which is essentially a two-barrel blaster, and I'm sure it itself would have been a unique piece, but it's not exactly, yeah, not much is gonna come to mind here. So we'll just leave this one at C, just the same. Same thing will go with the Improv and the True Legacy Ball. So a lot of C rankings we have today, but don't worry, because we have the very, very last piece that I'll be doing here, known as the Super Stripes Collection. And with this one, they have another three blasters that came out. We're gonna start with the 5x5. This was essentially another Hammer Shot ripoff. I mean, do they have to make the same blaster multiple times just for different lineups? I mean, there's really not much I could say about this. We'll put this at B because it's another Hammer Shot blaster, though I feel like it's a little generous. And the next blaster we have in the lineup is the Rapid Glow. This one has its own signature design, which is thankful, and it also has a magazine of its own. A nice bright blue with purple and white logo, already a unique color combo. And it also has a top slide on it, similar to way to that of the Recon or Retaliator, which is also pretty unique to try out, though I'm sure that it could have had its own motorized capabilities. But that's not to worry, because there were other blasters out there in the Rebel line that had battery power to it. So this one itself is a pretty good blaster in its own unique way, so we'll just leave it at the B tier, much like the 5x5. Though with more positives on hand, I feel like it could go a little bit higher. But not much to add on that part, so we'll just leave it at B. And the last blaster of this collection is the Wild Glam. Yep. Another jolt. So, C tier for this one as well. A lot of things have been mediocre and a lot of things have been rather repetitive. But that's totally okay. Because this is the end, everybody. This is the end of the Rebel lineup itself. Now, I know what you're thinking. I missed out on the Secret Spies collection. Yeah, Secrets and Spies is being left out on this one. Although, there is a reason for this, and that's because the Secrets and Spies collection has a huge library of blasters in its own way. So, that's a whole different episode of Tears of the Clown that I could save this for. So, you could consider it a Rebel Part 4, but really, it's all ended with the original series, Super Soaker lineup, and all these other sub-series minus Secrets and Spies. And if you want to see a tier list video on that, do be sure to comment down below, and make sure to like, subscribe, follow me wherever you can find me, and stay on the Hollywood side. And don't forget to comment again.